Shalom, everybody, and welcome to a very special edition from Meregavei Ivrit here from Israel. I hope that during this time you are being diligent in the study, practice of the Torah. And I just want to remind you, as the Meregavei Ivrit program is brought to you every week freely, that this will be a good and appropriate time for you to consider to supporting this work here of bringing the Meregavei Ivrit program to so many people in so many languages every week. Thank you for your support and your generosity. This week we are in Parashat Nitzavim, standing before Hashem. And I actually would like to focus on chapter 29 with the Chida, verse 27. It says there in the text, Vayashlechem el eretz acheret kayom hazeh. This is a very important verse, and this word vayeshlechem always have a messianic context. God says, I will cast them to another land in this day. What other land is it speaking about? Now, in order to understand this text, it's important for us to look at this word in the scroll. This word vayeshlechem have a very unique letter lamed. The lamed is a giant lamed that is called in Hebrew lamed gdola. It's a clue, and when we see letters in different shapes and sizes, we know that this is something that we have to pay attention to. Now, the letter lamed about being casted out, meaning to go to an exile, to the galut, is, the Chida explained, is a hint, is a remes for all of Israel. And he says this, when Israel removed this letter lamed, come from the word lamad, lamed, the letter comes from the word lamad, mean to study or to practice. To study what? To study the Torah. You see, when you remove the letter lamed from the word vayashlechem, you end up with the word vayashkem. Vav, yod, shin, chaf, mem. In essence, if you remove the lamed, the practice of the Torah, you end up with the word vayashkem. And why this is important? Because the word vayashkem is equivalent in gematria to the name Esav. You see, when the children of Israel stop studying Torah, stop practicing Torah, do not live according to the Torah, it's give an open door to Esav to come and to enter in. This is the key for us today. Why the Vayeshlechem take place? When the Lamed, the practice of the Torah, the study of the Torah of Gmilut Chasadim, when it's been removed, that means that Esav is an open door for to enter in into the house of Israel. So what do we have to do today? Focus on your lamed, starting on practice, on Torah, on mitzvah, on gemilut chasadim. This is how you keep Esav out of your life. I've prepared something very special to you today. Just a little bit bonus from southern Israel. Bonus Meregavei Ivrit today from the land. God bless you. And Shabbat Shalom from Zion. Shalom everybody and welcome to Rega Be'ivrit. Today Rega Be'ivrit is the most unusual Rega Be'ivrit that we have ever made. I call it Bamidbar edition. You see, I wanted to stop and explain to you where I'm at. I am in one of the most southern points in Israel with the border of Israel and Egypt. And I'm walking now in a place of Bamidbar. I am in the wilderness. Right behind me is the Gaza and Egypt. And right here, you see the sun is setting. Excuse me, rising, uprising. Oh my goodness, it is so early in the morning. And it's cool. I thought that today we will do something a bit different. We will talk about two words. The sun is rising from the east. What is the Hebrew word east? The Hebrew word east is the word mizrach. Me mizrach mean from the east. And we are watching right now those stones. Look at this. In the place called Midbar. And where is it rising? From the east. Now look at this. What is the Hebrew word to sunrise? The word for sunrise is the word zarach. Do you notice something amazing? That the word east, mizrach, and the word zarach, to shine, have the same root word. Zayin, resh, chet. Now look at how the connection is between the wilderness to Yeshua. It says that he is called the Davar. Davar Adonai. What is Davar? The word. What is the root of the word for wilderness? Davar. Bamidbar. If you look at the root of the word Bamidbar or Midbar, you have inside the word Davar. He is the word. Where does he found? Where does he go to? He go to the wilderness. And what does he do in the wilderness? He do something called Hitbodedut. He's along with the Father. Where is it that we found Mashiach? We find the Davar Bamidbar. You follow this? The Davar is found in Bamidbar. He found in the exile. He found in the Galut. Why is it? Because he himself had to go to the exile for the people of Israel. The Davar has to go to Bamidbar, same word, for his people Israel. And this is, friends, a reminder for all of us that he went to Bamidbar, like the goat that had to push off in Bamidbar for the salvation of his own people. What an amazing reminder it is for us. This is a very special Rega Be'ivrit about the Davar and the Midbar. Shalom, everybody.